Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a viewer call-in. Now, if you would like to call in, a couple of ways to do this. If you're in the United States, you can call the toll-free number, 866-581-0221. It leads to voicemail. Just say, hey, this is Joe from Chicago, and give your Excel question. Someone pointed out that's very inconvenient for everyone else around the world. If you happen to have a Skype phone and the Skype service, you can call me. It's B-I-L-L-J-E-L-E-N. Only one L and Jelen, everyone messes that up, and leave a voicemail there. And we also have a new Skype in number for people in the UK. This is a London-based number, 020-7871-4957. On those last four digits, that's 4XLS, if your Skype phone has the letters on the number. Just call in and leave your question on a voicemail. We'll get to it on a future podcast. I'd love to have calls because that gives me a chance to answer real-life questions from folks out there watching the podcast. So here's our call for today.
Hi Bill, it's Jim in Montreal. I had a chance to try out Excel 2007 at one of their technology stores over here. And I use the auto filter a lot, and I noticed that they've changed the auto filter and made it behave more like a pivot drop down where you have to uncheck values and check the values, as opposed to like Office 2003 where you just have a list of values and pick and choose ones where you go to the custom. Is this the way it really is, or is there a different way that we can use this? Thanks a lot. Love the podcast.
Hey, Jim, that's a great call. And this is a clear situation where what's a brand new feature for some people is really going to hack some other people off. Now, if you've never used the autofiller, let's take a look at how it works in the old version of Excel. Basically, select one cell in your data set, you'll go into Data, Filter, and then choose auto filter, and Excel will add a little drop down to the top of every column. Now the drop down has a list of all the values in the column, at least the first 1,000 values that it finds in the column. And so if you just want to see records for one particular customer, it's really simple to go there and select that customer and see just those records. Simple enough. One of the questions I get in the Power Excel seminar is, what if I need to see records for two customers or three customers? Well, it became much more difficult to do that. You would have to go in and say that we wanted a custom filter, and then I could say where the customer was Air Canada or equals Bell Canada. Click OK, and then I'd see the superset of both of those customers. If I needed to do three or more customers, though, I was completely out of luck. I had to switch over to the advanced filter, which is really one of the hard things to use. Now let's go take a look at Excel 2007 and how Microsoft solved that problem. In Excel 2007, when you turn on the auto filters, you'll see that it looks kind of like the new pivot table dropdown, as Jim mentioned, where we have a list of all the different customers, and if we want to select just one, it becomes much more difficult on the face of it. The first thing you have to do is click the checkbox for select all, and that unselects all of the customers, and then select the one customer that you want and click OK. So what used to be one click in Excel 2003 has now turned into three clicks in Excel 2007. The one great advantage, though, with this new auto filter is the ability to easily select three, four, five, six customers from the list without having to resort to the custom and joining things together with Boolean logic. Click OK, and there's a set of all those customers. So while we have a feature that I thought was pretty good and handles those obscure questions where you need to choose three, four, or five things from the auto filter, I can see that if you're a regular user of the auto filter and usually go through and select just one customer, this is going to seem like three times as much work as it was in the old version of Excel. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.